Hi, my name is Jane Kim, and I am finishing my very last day here at the Woodson Art Museum for a week-long residency. I am here from Half Moon Bay, California. I have a studio called Inkdwell, and we create work that explores the wonder of the natural world. I have a background in fine art and scientific illustration. You may be familiar with scientific illustration in textbooks and magazines like National Geographic, on journals online, but I really enjoy bringing information about the natural world through the visual arts, and I create public art installations as well as scientific illustrations in my work. The piece that I have created for the Woodson Art Museum is called RGBird. RGB is the color model that we see color with our eyes. It's also the color model that we use in screens and how we make sense of how light creates color. I chose this concept because I was fascinated by the color blue in the avian world. It doesn't exist as a pigment. So anytime you see a blue bird in the world, whether it's a blue jay or a blue bird or an indigo bunting in the case of this painting, what you're actually seeing is the light interacting with the feathers and reflecting the color blue back to our eyes. So that's really cool. I actually kind of can't believe it myself. Every time I see a blue bird, it's fascinating to me that it's not actually blue. It's a black or brown or gray color. So what I wanted to communicate in this piece was how various light sources create different shades of blue. So depending on how bright the sun is, we might see an indigo bunting as a very brilliant, almost turquoise blue, and sometimes we see it as almost black, and this piece illustrates that concept. And they're flying through a color wheel and showing the full spectrum of color. And I chose a white background because when you mix all colors of light together, they create white. And the shadows that you see here are indicators of a grayscale of light. So each bird responds to how much light would be hitting it at the moment. They're not meant to be literal shadows. So they're more interpretive and an informative device that I've chosen to use. If you look carefully at the painting, you'll not only notice that the shades of blue vary as you go up to the painting, but you might also recognize that there are a series of four indigo buntings in repeat on both sides. And I chose to repeat the birds just to accentuate the idea that that same bird might look very different in different lights. You can also see a texture in that white background. This is created by pecan wood. I actually painted on wood veneer, which meant it was really easy for me to transport the painting here. So I finished maybe 85% of the painting back at home in my studio, rolled it up, put it in a big tube, and brought it here. And together we mounted it on a panel that was prepared by the museum. So I really appreciate seeing the natural wood grain, and it gives the stark background some movement as well. I am so thrilled that this painting will be in the permanent collection here. I hope you have an opportunity to come see it in person while it's on view. If you'd like to learn more about me or Inkdwell, you can follow us on Facebook. You can also follow us on Instagram at Inkdwell, and our website is www.inkdwell.com. Thank you so much.